Okay, folks, another day of fishing Urbania. And like I said, I always cast early because they might be at the bank right in front of me. And if I spook them, I don't catch them. Nobody's there. Nobody's there. I greased up this reel a little bit. There's some oil on there. So that thing spins well. I just saw some fish jumping right here. Some bait, which means big ones are around. My lure is swimming funny. I need to get some crazy glue because if you get crazy glue, you can. Oops, sorry. Hold on. You can make your lure swim straighter and the rubber part won't slip up and down on the hook if you crazy glue it. And it takes a drop or two and you're all set. And you can actually attach yourself to a building rafter, they say, with a fishing lure on your hat. That's what they say on Facebook, so I believe it. Always believe what they tell you on Facebook because it's always fact. Oh, there's a fish. See? Oh, there's no more fish. There was a fish, then there's none. Was, then there's none. Isn't that sad? Oh. Hey. We see what happens if we catch another. Watch. That's the ocean's a big place. We're not in the ocean though. We are in the backyard of somebody else. I don't have backyard water. I have grass. Look. There he is. Boink. Got him. Got you. I got you, babe. I got you, babe. And you came off the hook into my hand. I'm going to put that in slow motion and reverse it a couple times and do a few. Oh, he's nice and warm. I'd say about 78 degrees. The temperature is 78, so that's usually when these fish are pretty active and they're feeding, about 75 to 78, maybe 76 to 79, maybe in that zone. Breathe. Y'all know me, you know how I earn a living. I'll catch this bird for you, but it's not gonna be easy. I don't wanna catch birds. What the hell's he talking about? I thought this was a fishing show. A bird show? Oh, he's insane, and that's okay because no one cares. No one cares anymore which way they go. Oh, there's another fish. There are everywhere. The fish are everywhere, folks. Everywhere. Do you hear it? I hear it. Sounds like distant thunder. No. See, now this is what happens. I'm going to show you my lure. You see, watch when it's in the water. Now it's straight. If it swims like a helicopter like that, that kind of doesn't do the trick for you. You won't catch anything except a real aggravation. Okay, they're there and they're eating. So I just need to get it to the right spot because they're not moving from their spot. They seem a little lethargic. Oh, that was crappy cast. But don't waste it. Cause see, it's doing its thing out there. So just reel it really fast sometimes, and that makes it feel better inside because you just want to break the rod. But you don't. Just reel it really fast and get it back to you. Sometimes when you reel it really quick, actually what I'm trying to insinuate here is that it actually straightens itself out. That's going to be the fish. You ready? Watch. That's going to be the one. Of course, I could always edit a fish there to make it look like I caught one, but I wouldn't do that to you. You know why? I'm honest TV guy. I'm different than the rest. My shows are real. My show is real. I do a show. I show you things. I'm show and tell is what this is. Show and tell. Do you like show and tell? Or do you like that rated R chat room that you like to show and tell in? Tell me. Tell me. What a world, folks. What a world. Somebody is on it, but they don't want it. The fact that there are some fish in the water, that's exciting. So exciting. Are you excited too? I'm very excited right now. Look. Jazz hands. Jazz hands. Yeah, that's how excited I am. Do you notice? Can you tell? Grasshopper, take stone from fish ass and you will live forever. But you must remove stone from fish's ass first. This is very difficult. Many have never left the aquarium, having never removed the stone from the fish's ass. I shall show you the way to do this, Grasshopper. And then you too shall be a fish proctologist. Going to walk gently around the lawn. You see, what's fun about these lawns, you can feel them caving in under the water, which means that soon they'll just be, this place will be underwater. maybe not. Is it worth it? I don't know. For me, it is. For me, it is. Everything's worth it for me. You know why? No, I'm asking you. Why are these things worth it to me? Why does it matter? Why do I care? Answer in 3 sentences or less. Fish. Come on, you were just accommodating me. Did I hit my microphone? You were just accommodating the show. The show. And now there's no fish to speak of. So, see how that thing swims? Just like a lure that swims like that. That's how it swims. It's absolutely fantastic. See, like that is what you don't want. That's called bad. And that's because the lure has a little bend in it. So what you do is you can, if you take the tip of that and you just kind of pop it in there, that gives a little more support to the whole apparatus. There he is. There he is. He missed it the first time, but he got it the second. Will he take the third? Nope. There might have been a ga. We have ga here. Ga. Like ka. Ga. I think he chased it that time, but didn't even engage. No, engage! That's what you want to see is the slurp. Once you pull it over those reeds right there, they slurp it. It's the magic slurp. It's like when you get it's like the first sip of a really good milkshake, you know, the magic slurp. Look right there, you see the tilapia? I think you can see it. It's a big white fish underwater. I'll keep my head as still as I can and move with the fish or my finger. He's right there. He's going deeper now. Watch, I'll spook him. Ready? I'll make the water move. Ready? Watch. Nope. He ran away from the lure, but he didn't like spook like I wanted to. I wanted to make a big swell in the water. It's kind of fun. I could do things like that. I have magic fish friends. They accommodate my videos. See, now the lure's doing weird spastic movements. We don't want that. That's no good. But I don't have any crazy glue, so I can't fix it. Unfortunately. And but you know what I say to that? Not that much. I don't have much to say to anything anymore except stuff that I feel might be pertinent. Something just bit it, but they let it go. See, the bass will actually inhale that lure and spit it out faster than you can ever feel a bite. So generally, what you're trying to do when you're fishing for bass is you're watching the line often. You're watching the surface of the water, if it moves in any direction that you're that looks different. That's what you're looking for. This lure is messed up. I have to rehook it, recapitulate. I brought a couple. I have a couple. But what I'll do is I'll just see how far down it wants to hang on there. Just rehook it in the bottom. Put a new spot. Find a new spot so that it glides through the water as straight as possible. Now, these lures, I'll show you a trick here. These lures right here, unless you put this thing up and leave and only use the very tip of this lure, this whole thing will get all kind of wiggly and be wrong. My favorite way to use this is with a tiny circle hook about the size of my thumb, right in the tip, and just pull it straight through the water. The whole thing's hookless except for the tip. Fish will engulf this thing, swallow it whole. Swallow you whole. Down you go, shaking, tenderizing, and down you go. Anyway, the point I'm trying to make is that the further up on this lure you go, the better the ballast of the lure and the better the balance. See, look at it. That twisting, like corkscrewing, is no good. You can't have that. That means that I set this up in the wrong place. And now here's a perfect example of what not to do. You see the way that thing sits right there? That's no good. So you come back on the lure that way. Okay? And what you do also to make it weedless, bring it back here. And what you do to make it weedless is you take that little piece there. Take that little piece there and put this. Now you see where we're going to cast. Something just snapped on the surface. Could be a little gator, I don't know. But it might be a big fish too. So we'll put this right there. It thinks that's the thing it just went after because it missed whatever it went after. Or it got it, but it might think that's another half of it and it comes back and eats it. Or somebody else eats it thinking it missed. That's the competition cycle in the water with fish. If you ever watch a fish tank, you'll see this happen all day long. And that's a good thing to see happen. But it seems that these fish are picking this thing up and putting it down pretty quickly. So my trick would be to the minute I see any kind of difference in that line is to set the hook or at least keep the lure moving so that anytime a fish strikes, there'll be a sudden stop. You know, that sudden stop will tell you there's a fish there. like that one. See the sudden stop? Okay. There he is. He was in that. There's a stick over there and he went in it. Got him this time. He doesn't know he's hooked yet. Woo, this time he does. He's like, hey, wait a minute, I'm going the opposite direction of which I came. Lighten the drag, he's a runner. It's a nice fish, it's a better fish. Okay, let's get him in. Okay, come on up on the shore. If they're swimming towards shore, keep them going towards shore. There you go. No problem. Nobody even knew you were even hooked. You didn't even know, did you? You had no idea. You're just going the wrong direction. He's going the wrong direction. Got some bad breath on that fish. Eyes both are intact. Beautiful, beautiful bass. Is that a largemouth? Yes, it is. Largemouth bass. Let you go, sweetheart. Okay. Mouthful of that water make you go to the hospital. Oh shit. Okay, so I was gonna go for a bad joke there, but I left it out because you know what? People don't have a sense of humor in this world at all. Except you folks. You do. So you know the joke without me even saying it. It's a one-liner. I like story jokes personally, but one-liners are fun. So that fish hit on the actual strike, on the actual move, I mean, on the run. So I'm gonna send it back over there because he was a schoolie. So there might be some other buddies with him. He's a smaller bass. A bass and a half would be better. A little bass is good, but a bass and a half is even better. Usually they just fly out of this shoreline and wallop the thing, you know, like they're ambush predators. Fish that are ambush feeders, ambush predators, will sit sedentary, not sedentary completely, but they'll sit and wait under the edges of things and stuff. And that will be the white meat fish you get at restaurants. That's the white meat stuff. Stuff that sits pretty much most of the time, it doesn't swim all the time, has a lighter meat because it has less blood vessels in the meat. Fish that swim all the time, like tuna and mackerel, they have to swim all the time because they're ram breathers. They have to ram the water past their gills to breathe. And so those fish have a red body meat because of the amount of blood vessels to keep them oxygenated. That's an athlete fish, wahoo, marlin. Now wahoo might have a little bit more white meat in it, but it definitely has a pinkish tinge to it. So, you know, some fish are exceptionally, they might be a little bit different because they don't. Here's the thing, wahoo are not constantly swimming as much as a tuna will be. They're more of like a marlin, where they're swimming in circles a lot. They're swimming to feed a lot. They will hang out over wrecks and stay. They will stay like barracuda, like in the water column without having to move. Whereas a tuna can't just sit in the water column. You understand? I mean, a wahoo could sit on a reef, a wreck in a reef, and never move. Whereas a tuna can't do that. It has to constantly move. That's the difference. So you'll see wahoo meat is white. And people say, well, wahoo, I catch with tuna. I know, but it's a different type of thing. They're feeding in the same area, but that fish is sitting on a wreck and then comes up to eat, whereas the tuna just came by on its migration or on its feed or whatever it's doing. You savvy my talking, my English, my speaks. You savvy my speaks, my talks, my words is... Well, anyway, so now you get a little bit of a understanding of why meat is, fish meat is red and some fish meat is pink and some fish meat is just white. But bass meat is white, basically, because they're always just kind of sitting on a structure someplace and hanging. And they'll swim around, don't get me wrong, but they're not. Right there, that was probably a carp or a pleco. The same pleco you have in your fish tank are everywhere here. It was called armored catfish, plecopotamus. Maximus is not, no, it's not the scientific name. It's pleco. Someone say it for me, please. Help me out. Help the marine biologist remember his lessons class. We need to have a whole class on pleco, so that's like, you know, I have to learn that on your own. It wasn't like they said, okay, today we're going to learn about plecos. You have to, those kind of things, they give you the basic of fish, then you go and learn different fish on your own. So marine biology, you're not going to go in a class and be like, today we're talking plecos. You're only going to talk about the fish that are seriously important in a migration and an evolutionary scale, or for the Earth's continual cycles. This is the predatory species, the apex critters, the ones that really, really matter. And then they'll talk about, in marine biology, they'll talk about all the smaller fish that are feeding the bigger fish. And there's a 10% rule, and that the bigger fish, the predators have to eat 10% of their body weight in order, every day, in order to survive, to keep up with the cycle of life. They have to eat 10% of their weight in fish. So you can see the ocean and the water is a smorgasbord. And these fish always, look, there's right there going across, is that white tilapia? Somebody's over there, but I don't think I cast to a good spot. Is it monkeys? Oh, we got monkeys? I don't think I cast far enough that time. Try again. There's a underwater structure here. Oh, that's over to the right. What was that? Gargantua. Just kind of move it, mosey it slow through there. You don't have to speed it. This lure has the best action when it actually stops. So as you're pulling it and it stops, it turns like this. I'll show you in front of me. Watch. We could demonstrate. I didn't bring my underwater camera, so just watch the birdie. Watch. Do you see the lure? Watch what happens when I stop it. The tail has a little bulb on it, so it kind of does this little wiggle on the way down, and that gives it its own action while it's moving. It doesn't need your work all the time. So this is called a trick worm, and I don't make any money from the company, but it's a trick worm, and you can find out the name of it. It's Zoom. I'm going to tell you. It's not a big deal. It's not like they're going to go out of business if I don't tell you, and it's not like they're going to do anything better if I do, but at least you'll be able to catch some fish. Wasn't that nice of me? So I sacrificed the fact that I'm a billboard for Zoom so you can catch some fish. You gotta love me for that. Come on, folks. Oop, there he is. There he is. I got him this time. Run away, Frank. Run away. That's going slow motion and then fast motion. But why did I run away? Because the fish was coming at me. And that's it, because I didn't have enough speed on the reel to catch up with the fish. He was coming at me so fast, I couldn't catch up with him. So that's another bass. And that is a Florida spotted or a largemouth. Can't tell. The hinge of the jaw doesn't go back past the eye far enough, so I'll say that's a Florida spotted. And he's ready to go back. And we'll do that again. Anybody tallying up the score, how many fish we got here in this last hour of sunlight? Not too bad, huh, folks? See, the fish come back when they do less of that stuff, too. It really affects the waterways, and of course, you know, it's not the cars not going by. Don't let that kid you, okay? Cards have been coming back here, going by here for a long time now, and I have seen the largest fish be caught in here, and the cars were in here already 30, 40 years with a lot worse emissions, a lot worse fuel, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, yeah, so usually it's a, and it could be on a migration. Fish like to migrate. They like to move around. They have to mate. They have to do stuff. A lot of these are little fish. Like, they're looking about a few months old to, like, a year. So, not a few months old. Like maybe 6 months to a year old these fish are. So, they probably just mated and moved into here. And they're setting up beds for the next year. So, they can mate this year coming up. I'm so excited. I ran away because the actual, the fish was coming at me so fast that I didn't have a chance, setting the hook wasn't quick enough. And that becomes an issue. So when you're on a beach and stuff, I'll be running up and down, oh, there, he's on it. I'll be up and down the beach so people think I'm doing aerobics or something with my fishing pole. They think I'm getting some exercise. And mainly because I'm, just running up and down. So I fight the fish actually by running up and down the beach as well as with the rod. You know, I use the beach as my help, and I'll use this bank as my help if I need to, because why not? When people are on a boat fishing, that's what they do. You see people like deep sea fishing on TV, and if you're not a boater, you don't maybe know what they're doing, but they're taking up slack in the line. So, you know, you have a fish that swims 30, 40 miles an hour, and you have a boat, or 30, 40 knots, and you have a boat that's only going 15 knots. Once that fish takes the hook, you have to be able to pull slack up out of the line so you can set the, you know, basically keep connection. And so they drive the boat fast so it keeps it tight. And you'll drive in a boat really fast for quite some distance until you actually know you have a connection on the fish. Also pulls a fish off the reef or wreck or wherever you have caught the fish. It's not going to, like, hang you up in some kind of structure. See, these are all tips. I'm trying to drop all the tips I can on you in the short time we have left to drop tips on each other. However time that is. I mean, who knows how long I have left on YouTube. So let me get all the tips I can to you so you know how to fish wherever you are. I'm not asking for anything. Just doing that because I like to fish with you people. You know, I like to take people fishing. I always wanted to be a fishing guide. And unfortunately, right now, I don't think that's a possibility anymore. So, hey, c'est la freaking vie, right? You want to shut the dogs up? Thank you. I'm trying to do a show over here, people. Quiet on the set. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Quiet on the set. You're fired. Someone get those mutts out of here. See, I'm just keeping it over there as long as I can and ticking it along, but it's all hung up, the lure, so let's get it back over here and see what I got wrong. No, it's fine. Just my own imagination is what's wrong. I'm just working the shoreline. I like to drop it onto the actual beach itself and then pull it off the beach into the water. A, it doesn't make a splash, spook any kind of fish because they don't know what the heck it is. And B, it enters the water kind of like a snake does. And so with that in mind, we have water snakes here. And if there was an albino one, it would be the first one on the meal. So they fall out of trees often. That one might have fallen out of a tree. Let it sit for a minute like it's stunned from the water, and then you just kind of wiggle it in one spot. And generally, you're going to get a strike on these. They represent basically snakes more than they do worms. Of course, you could fish it like a worm, but there's not too many worms that swim like this. I find this works great in saltwater as well. These are fantastic saltwater lures. You could troll these behind a boat if you wanted on a umbrella rig. Just hook them very close to the tip. That's my only suggestion, would be don't hook them in the body. If you're trolling, hook, see like that? You want it to swim straight like that, like, kind of like it looks like a squid strip. These would satisfy a squid strip imitation if you ever needed something like that, just to attract the fish to the boat. Say if everybody's using squid, you run out, and all you have is this, you might catch the fish. Look at it. It looks just like a piece of squid. I mean, that looks like a strip, you know? Like if you've ever squid strip fished, you're surprised they got those words out, aren't you? So am I. Squid strip fished? Sounds like the name of a band. Oh, that's squid strip fished, man. They're a fish cover band, but they're actually fish are in the band. They're actually fish. The people are fish. And they eat squid strips, man. Psychedelic. Squid strippers. Well, fishing's always been a good pastime for me. It's always been a way to pass the time. Let's keep working our way back, because you know what? I think I caught all the fish. There are no more fish left in the sea, because Frankie has caught them all. Yes, sirree. That's why, folks, you know that. You know this to be true. I am the greatest fisherman that ever lived. Ever. I've caught all the fish. Everyone. Oh, look what... Ninja. Look what the ninja did. He got it stuck in a tree. Oh my, oh wee. Oh, crud. What do we got happening here, folks? This is just bad. It's really silly kind of stuff going on. Gotta collect all the line. I'm lazy. I could get up there and pick it up, but I have special skills with stupidity. So, you know. Hey, I hope you're having a good time with me fishing the bank of the river Siam. Fishing the bank of the old mighty river. This is what we call the Easter fishery. This is Ether Thunday. Coming up here, folks. So this is actually Ether Saturday. Tomorrow's Ether Thunday. The ether that represents the air between my head. Ears, I mean. You know, the air in my head between my ears. See, I can't even get that out right. Yes, this has all been so great for my psyche. Just joyful and triumphant. Come on, where's my fish? Hey, where are you? Come on, fish, where are you? See how sweet, look. I mean, you could troll this. You would have a great day trolling that. You would be trolling the rivers and trolling them well. Promise you. I don't lie, man. I tell you, why would I bother? I got nothing better to do than lie to you, because I want to be on Facebook lying to people about how good of a fisherman I am. I just show you. I'll catch every freaking thing in here. Frankie has got to stay away from the old binger. Because the binger just keeps him happy and complacent during the world's takeover crisis crash monkey effing thing. This is like watching monkeys with a football. You know that old saying? Yes, sirree. Watching everybody out there deal with the situation is like monkeys with a football on steroids with a box of Viagra and somebody directing, timing, with like clapping their hands, timing, and a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, jam it. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Friends don't let friends count on 1 and 5. I mean, friends don't let friends clap on 1 and 5. Unless it's a 5-7 beat. Or a 5-8 beat or something, you know? Signature, that's the signature. It's got a signature like somebody signs it. They sign it with their signature. You know what a signature is, right? Of a song? That's the tempo. You learn music with me, you learn fishing, you learn nonsense and stupidity, all kinds of good stuff. You can't have a better time educating the noodle than with somebody else. See, if you really follow me, you got what I just said, because I said that you can't learn a damn thing from me. And there you go. So let's try to catch a fish. Maybe it'll shut me up. That's what I say. Come on, let's try over here. This looks really exciting. It's a brand new place. Let's see. Doodly-doo-doo-doo-doo, fishing in the yard. Doodly-doo-doo-doo-doo, it's not very hard. Doodly-doo-doo-doo, fishing in the yard. Get yourself a pole and string and then you'll have some... It's a beast! It got me a tarpon! And we lost the hook and things and now we're gonna cry. At least I didn't get it stuck deep within my eye. I think I can find it if I look real hard. It is right there, it hasn't left the backyard. Gotta reline my pole. Gotta pack another bowl. Gotta realize my time on earth is old. Going down toilet bowl. Oh, you stinky dog, you. This is why I keep my hand underneath the guide that I'm like tying from, because you know, you move your hand up because as it slides out into the abyssal, you're upset because then you have nothing left but tears. Just tears. Am I recording? Yes, I am recording. Tell Marsha, Greg, and Peter that I'm recording. The video is secure and sound and safe and good and stuff. Look, I'm gonna have to step into some water here. Oh, look, there's an island. No man is an island and his castle isn't home. So what are you having for dinner tomorrow? You gonna eat something? What are you getting at Walmart? You're going to use the dinner at Walmart tomorrow, aren't you? I know that. You know how I know? Because that's the only thing you're going to be able to ever get dinner at. Walmart. Remember ingredients that were good and you can make a real... Hey, chefs out there. Remember when food was actually really good? I know you know what food's like, you chefs out there, because you guys... You know what it's about. See, I cook food. I'm a cook. And so I know what it's about when there's no ingredients left to pick from, except Walmart crud. There's no imported stuff, and I need my gabagool. If I don't get my gabagool, we're gonna have a real problem this Easter. Mom, you hear me? There better be some gabagool tomorrow. We're gonna have to do something about this thing here. We're gonna have to make a few calls and get some gabagool. Otherwise, I don't know what I'm gonna do. This lure is all mangled and spangled and bangled. So what we're going to do is put this into the melt pot. That goes into the melt pot. Take that off the hook. I got another one right there in the pocket. And I got this one here in the pocket here. See what I do here is I put this on the hook like this. Got a whole pack of these things right here. Ain't that funny? This one causes you cancer. See right here? Look at that. Warning. Cancer and reproductive harm. www.p65warning.california.gov. Made in the USA, and on the front, look how proud they are. Look at that beautiful seal. They're so damn proud that this is a cancer-causing bait for young children. Young children have themselves a little bit of cancer and fish all together in one day. Isn't that nice? Don't you want to thank them? Don't you want to thank them by sending them a candy bar? Send them a candy bar. How you like them apples? Am I standing in an anthill here? Just go send them a candy bar. People are afraid to come outside in their backyard. I'm not fucking kidding you. I have to bleep that, don't I? Why? This isn't a kid's show. I never said it was. F this and F that there, okay? Gabagool for you, gabagool for me. Don't mess with the gabagool. Did you eat the gabagool? Who ate the gabagool? Tell me now who ate the gabagool. Gabagool. Nancy's my friend here. I hope she doesn't mind. I'm squatting in her yard fishing. Oh, there we go. He's swimming at me, so you have to reel fast. Now he's swimming away from me. And he let go. He didn't even have a hook on it. Do you see that fish was so hungry? He just had this thing in his mouth.
That whole time, that fish didn't let go of this because it just didn't realize I should just open my mouth and it'll fall out.
It seemed like the monkey with the hand in the cookie jar.
Yeah,
that's how that worked. I'm not going to complain, are you? There's a fish. Damn, I'm going to try that again. That was a fish just now bit that. Nobody. All right. Let it sit for a minute. This one would go really slow. It's kind of a little, a tweak. And these things kind of have a walk the dog action underwater, as you can see. See that back and forth action? You can even catch redfish and snook on this thing. No lie, this is like the best lure I've ever used for just grabbing something off a shelf, and the amount of stuff you can catch. Of course, there's some other lures that have amazing action that work just as well, but I'm talking about just for a one of these little goofy worms, they have so much versatility. Look at that thing. It's good, that brown water in the shadow, you can see it. I used to use another one, but I couldn't find them in them. They were made out of pig lard. They were, I don't know what they were called. They were like these ginormous 8-inch things like this, and they had like almost a submarine or a boat, a boat profile, like a battleship profile. And so the way they swam through the water, they had an amazing ballast, and so that they were perfectly, they looked so realistic. And I caught some of my biggest snook on those ever. I caught like, 48 inch snook on those things. It looks like a snake right there. See that? Look, watch. Right there. That's how a snake swims through the water, for the most part. I mean, I'm not the best imitator of snake. Oh, come on. Usually, sometimes if you pull good tension and then you run with it, well, you lose it all. Anyway, folks, that's it. That's all she wrote. I don't have any more hooks. So, let me wish you a happy day and have a good Easter tomorrow. I'll talk to you tomorrow. There'll be another episode. I'm going to be eating tomorrow, so I'm going to be finding some street corner fisheries on the way to get some dinner at my awesome family's house. And the evening is yours, folks. Thanks for joining me on G-Fish Outdoors for another episode in everybody else's backyard of fishing in Albania, where we try to catch dinner in sewers and backyard canals, bucket, toilet bowl, whatever you got handy, we'll try to catch a fish in. We're gonna be, when the summer comes, we'll be fishing in there, so you'll be able to, if you can see in there right now, there's some water and there's actually these trees in there. Hey there, she's trying to come up there for some light. There's a whole room under here. And you can actually lift this one up right here. This one comes up, I think. Yeah. And you go down there. There's actually a ladder and stuff. Oh, this one here. Watch. Oh, the middle one's loose here. I'm not strong enough. It's like 200-300 pounds. Anyway, so we'll be fishing in there this summer too. And that's that. So I hope you had a good time. That's a turtle carcass. I'll send him to the abyss. All right, folks, have a good day. Enjoy the evening. To the channel if you can on YouTube. It'll always help me out. It's just fun. You get some videos from me. I do a lot of videos on there. I got about 70 other fishing videos, I think, so you'll be able to catch on, and you can watch some old stuff and get some new stuff and just keep up with the videos. Click that little bell and you get a reminder and stuff and all that good jazz. And I'm not making any money from it, so if you want to jump on my Patreon, I would be more than appreciative of that and grateful to you for that, because that's how I'm going to be making a living, I see, in this new futuristic experience we're having called the world. Anyway, fishing in Albania, where we go from this to that, trees and whatever, in one quick glance. So from manicured nature with
cigarette butts on the floor and dog poop everywhere. Frank at G-Fish wishes you a happy day and happy holidays, if it is going to be happy for anybody. Buongiorno.